Hi, my name is Joe and I'm a chemical engineer at Stolly Catalysts. In this video, I'm going to be talking to you about batch reactors and explaining the pros and cons of this type of reactor system. Batch or stir tank reactors are simply vessels that hold the reactants and allow them to mix. The batch reactor contains four main components. First, the vessel. The vessels vary in size from small round bottom flasks like this to tens of thousands of litres. Second, the reaction medium. Third, headspace. This is an empty space above the medium. Finally, agitation. Agitation is crucial as it allows the mixing of several components and allows us to introduce or remove reaction heat. At this scale, we could use a magnetic stirring bar. We can also add a range of sensors to measure reaction conditions such as temperature, pressure, and pH. So, what reactions can be carried out in batch reactors? Batch reactors are used in the manufacture of most chemicals as almost any reaction can be carried out in them. The versatility of this type of reactor means it can accommodate liquids and liquids with more small solids present. The solids could either be reactants or catalysts. Here we're going to add a carbon-based catalyst. We could also have several phases such as two immiscible liquids or even gases. As you can see, the batch reactor can handle pretty much anything. The vessel could be made of chemically resistant materials like glass or some metals and hold high pressure and temperature. So, are batch reactors scalable? Batch reactors go from microliters to many cubic meters. Here we have a small vial used for screening experiments. These are useful when we want to test out a lot of different reactions at the same time. Once the reaction parameters have been optimized, we can start to think about carrying it out at a larger scale. Scaling up batch processes is well known. However, each process is different and each one can present different challenges. It is doable, but not as easy as transferring everything to a larger vessel. How much control over the reaction do you have? The key challenge of scalability is heat and mass transfer. The fluid velocity does not change proportionally to the reaction volume, so stagnant areas are formed with large variations in fluid velocity. Let's see what happens when we add a droplet of dye into a small reactor. As you can see, the mixing is rapid and colour becomes uniform. When the dye is added to a large reactor, it takes more time to mix. We have scaled the reactor liquid and stir volume by a factor of 25. Here you can see the mixing of the large reactor is less efficient compared to the smaller reactor. Increasing the stirrer speed or using a larger stirrer can improve the mixing. As a result, the product quality may be limited by the reactor and not just the chemistry. So, how energy efficient are batch reactors? Energy consumption comes from several sources. Firstly, the reaction itself may require and consume heat. Heat is also constantly being lost to the environment. Therefore, the reactor requires a constant input of heat to maintain the temperature. The heat loss is proportional to the external surface area. At the end of the reaction, the contents of the batch reactor are emptied and the whole process starts again. This means that all the heat is lost to the environment and the reaction mixture, and all of this has to be heated again. Using a larger reactor means more energy needs to be added and also more energy to keep the temperature constant. Finally, for catalytic reactions, what is the catalyst lifetime in batch reactors? The catalyst is added as a slurry, a suspension of small particles, yet there are still several problems. During the reaction, the impeller crushes the catalyst into smaller particles. Therefore, it becomes challenging to separate the catalyst from the product, which means it is rarely reused. This results in low catalyst lifetime and a lot of waste. So, we've discussed batch reactors. Their main advantage is their simplicity. That is why they're used in almost all chemical processes. We have given each type of reactor a subjective rating based on five parameters: reaction scope, scalability, reaction control, energy efficiency, and catalyst lifetime. So, for the batch reactor, we've given it 5 stars for its reaction scope. You can use the batch reactor for almost any reaction, and the exceptions are rare. For scalability, we've given it 4 stars. Although there are some challenges, the scalability of batch reactors is good. Reaction control is rather limited. Fast reactions require expensive cryogenic conditions, whereas slow reactions work quite well. Energy efficiency is rather average due to the heat required every time at startup and the potentially huge size of the reactors. The catalyst lifetime is moderate to poor because of the separation and recovery is often challenging. So overall, the batch reactor scored 17 out of 25. They are good, but there is still some room for improvement. If you want to learn more about other types of reactors, check out our other videos here. And to see what else we get up to, be sure to visit our website.